everybody. Watercolor postcard demo. So these are watercolor postcards that you can use to just like paint, and then they're sturdy enough that you can then send in the mail.
What are you working on here?
Well, I accidentally just like squished out like really expensive paint onto the table.
Brilliant.
And now I'm putting it on this postcard instead of the table.
It's a good excuse to use some yellow.
Yeah, you know, yellow. It's a nice color. This is sort of the test one.
Test spot.
Yeah.
Are those the stabilos?
Yeah, aren't they cool?
Yeah, those are. I've only seen them on the black retreat, so that's what looks really cool on the white.
Yeah.
Work. That's where I'm like, okay.
watercolors get all dried out like this, but that doesn't mean you can't use them. You're able to squish them out, or if you want to be real exciting and cut open your tube, this like dried up paint will still be perfectly good. And that's something that's really nice about watercolors that doesn't happen with acrylic. Like with acrylic, once it's dry, it's dry. But with watercolor, when it's dry, it just means you just add water. Usually what I'll do is I'll use them to do my like underdrawing or to do my drawing, okay. And then I'll go ahead and take a wet paintbrush and then just go ahead and do it. Yeah. Or if I just want to use them basically as a reservoir for watercolor, mm-hmm. I'll just like take my wet paintbrush and like use it on the actual just paint the tip of it. And then pick up the color that way. Another thing you can do too is even just getting like a rough piece of cold pressed watercolor paper or mixed media paper, like, you know, color yourself some scratches and then use that, I don't think you actually need, I mean, like, this is great for, like traditional watercolors like this, but I don't know if that's necessary for the watercolor pencil.
So, which one would you use something like this for? Like,
yeah, so.
Because it's rough texture on paper, is that, like, a different thing you would
take care?
Well, I would just, this would be great for squeezing out tubed paint, tubed watercolor just like these. Mm-hmm. So, we're all used to seeing watercolor when it comes in cakes like this.
Yeah.
But this is just dried up tubed watercolor.
Okay.
So, when you squish this out, which is what I'm doing right now, actually, is creating these little palettes for people to use for our watercolor demo. But, so, you can just squish out watercolor just like that.
Yeah.
And then, this will, if I were to leave this out, it would get all dried up like this. This palette is like years old, and I can just...
But then you can still use it.
Yeah, I can just reconstitute it.
That's nice.
No problem. That's one of the things that's really cool that's about watercolors.
Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, that's awesome. I just have like so many watercolor pencils that have been given to me. I've been trying to use them, but I'm interested in using them.
For both our Daniel Smith, which is this brand here, and our M. Graham tube watercolors, which are our two high-end watercolors, we're doing bi-treatment and free. We have free colors behind the counter that you can choose from.
Oh,
so if you're interested in dipping your toes into it, this is a good month to do it because it's watercolor month here at Edmonds.
Yeah.
So we have the buy three, get one free.
Okay, watercolor month. Oh, yeah.
Dan Smith is a world-class color house, and it's actually located right here in Seattle.
Okay.
And they're considered like top bar around the world.
Mm-hmm.
But M. Graham is up and coming. They're based in Portland.
Okay.
So that's really cool too. We're really lucky in the Northwest to have such these like huge powerhouses of color.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah, but if you're looking for something just to tip your toes in, we actually have like a beginner watercolor section that does have some tuned options as well.
Okay.
Yeah. There's something really, really nice about making the switch from the cakes to the tubes because you just get to, you have a lot more control, especially with it, once you're getting into color mixing.
Yeah, I know, because I'm not even thought about the color mixing and which ones go together. So that's why, if you were to get three tubes, would you recommend just getting like the primary colors?
I would absolutely recommend getting the primary
colors.
That's
what I should probably do.
Yeah.
Because you're always attracted to like, whatever, you can make it, right? With colors.
But, like, if you have a color that you know you like, and, you know, it comes in a tube form, like, instead of mixing it all the time, just go ahead and
get
the
more consistent one,
But, and some of the colors, especially with Dan Smith, they have, like, these really, really unique ones where it's all these, like, metallics and things like that, and I have no idea how you would mix those.
Right, right. So then if I was to get those tubes, we'd recommend just getting, like, one of those little ones.
Yeah.
Like, just something simple, you don't need, like, the
basic thing. Yeah, for me, I like this because it just kind of depends on what you're wanting to do with it.
Mm-hmm.
This is nice with the wells because it keeps your colors separate.
Yeah, different ones.
But if you are anticipating like mixing a bunch of your own colors, a nice flat surface. That's why I often see ones like this where it has like the wells and then it has a bigger flat surface where you can, you know, mix those colors together.
Yeah, those are nice, huh?
Yeah, because like if I wanted to mix like this red and this blue together to try and get purple, which I would not recommend, by the way. This is a warm red and a warm blue.
Yeah.
You might get a funky looking purple with those particular two shades. But in this little tiny palette, I don't really have the space to do that.
Yeah, so that's true. That's a good point, too.
One of the things that's really great about art supplies and why there's such varieties is because you really do develop your own preferences.
Yeah.
And there's no right or wrong answer in what works for one artist might not work for you, or they have a different technique than you. But it's really great to try out things and see what works for you.
Yeah. I'll go over there and see if I can see what
the dance is. Our
watercolor section is just on the other side of that white cabinet right there.
Yeah, go ahead and
hang
left, and then you'll see our watercolor section.
We just happened to come down here today. It's really good day to be at Edmonds. Like, yeah, I looked at Edmonds just on the 5th of October. All of this is on Thursday. We go to the lake, and we either go to artists, or we don't really do some demos. So, yeah, it's like a weird time where things are actually going on.
Hi, welcome to ArtSpot. Go ahead and put on your mask while you're inside.
Thank you.
Hi, go ahead and put on your mask while you're inside. Thank you.
Thank you.
bright spot.
Hi. How are you?
Doing good.
I
just banged my. Someone stole a old chai latte on the floor.
Oh,
I banged my head. No damage at all. That's just me.
Are you bleeding?
No, it's just an old
chai. You're getting all old spot.
I don't know. But it's okay. I'm on ibuprofen. I can't take it back.
Is this tomorrow's already?
No.
Yeah. Today is the
doing a demo?
Kinda, yeah. I'm demonstrating watercolor postcards.
Oh, that's fun. That's
yeah.
a fun thing to do.
Absolutely. Would you like to fill one out? Or?
No, he's the artist.
All right. But
I don't paint, but I like to watch you.
Yeah. I'm just sort of, I just finished like putting out all my colors for people to play with, and this one has ended up being kind of just, I don't know. I don't really have a plan with this one.
It's best not to have a plan,
yeah.
I understand. That allows for your creativity to
yeah.
burst through, right?
Yeah, we'll see what happens with this one.
And these are all kind of pretty. Look how gorgeous these are.
Yeah. We sell these as individual colors over in our watercolor section.
Okay.
Some are moist materials.
They're watercolors.
Yeah, these are all watercolors.
Is your mom not here tonight?
No, she's she'll be here later, but she's not here quite yet.
Okay, well, we might talk a little bit.
Yeah, she had a meeting at 5,
no,
so she'll be back at 5.
Like, this is one of like, the funnest times down there. Yeah, and like, over COVID, it was so sad and empty, so we had art for her.
Postcard.
Yeah, I'm just messing around, but yeah, if you'd like to make a watercolor postcard,
no thanks.
You can take it with you.
No,
I know him. He's hungry. We gotta go eat.
Oh yeah, we don't want to disrupt that for sure.
Yeah.
I'm just kind of messing around here.
Yeah, you're good at it though.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
You enjoying the vlog?
Huh?
Have you painted the vlog?
Myself as more of a drawer than,
yeah.
A,
yeah.
than a painter. So this is like really different for me. I actually studied animation in college.
Oh, you did?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I used to work down in Los Angeles.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Worked in television and movies. But
oh, wow.
Now I'm back up here. This is my family store helping out.
Oh.
Yeah.
And how are you related?
Chrissy's
daughter. Oh, you're Chrissy's daughter. Oh, for God's sake. Yes, so.
Yeah.
That's a big bath. Why don't we take the mask off?
Oh, I know, right? Hopefully soon. I'm so sick of wearing this.
Thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Because we're both fully vaccinated. Are you vaccinated too?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
I think we'll have to make us, have to wear a mask.
Yeah.
But, I know.
But I'd rather be safe than sorry.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, of course. Oh, my God. Yeah.
Yeah.
Something new thing comes through.
Oh, yeah.
Safe.
Yeah, I'll probably take it off in like, I don't know, hopefully a couple of weeks.
Well, hopefully, maybe July 1st at home.
Oh, that would be amazing.
We'll be able to do it then.
Well, thank you so much. Have a lovely day.
Did you see?
Would you like to paint a postcard?
Yes.
All right, here you are. I've got pens, I've got paintbrushes, I've got metallic paints. Here you are. Would you like to paint one as well?
Yes.
Okay, there you go. What size brush would you like?
This.
There you go. Would you like a brush as well?
Yeah.
All right, good choice. So you know how watercolors work?
Uh-huh.
All right, dip your brush in the water. Wake up whatever watercolor you like and have fun painting.
I'm gonna put two on the towel.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Where is
it? Yeah, I haven't opened those ones up yet. Nobody's played with them yet.
But this is closer to this.
I think you might have to use a layer or two of this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's pretty transparent. Yeah. If you like sparkly ones, try these ones too.
Those are pretty.
Mm-hmm. Classroom into more store space. But if you go onto our website, we have different links to local classes. We also have an online drawing course. It's called Drawbridge.
I overcomplicate everything.
Getting all these pretty sparkly colors all
woken
up.
Grandma's really cool.
I like getting like different sparkles.
Yeah, it's kind of like a rainbow of sparkles.
But it sets Grandma apart from a lot of
colors. It kind of almost looks like it's, like this could be the mountains and this could be the sea and this could be the sky at like a really crazy diagonal. But maybe this is because I'm just looking at it upside down. Yeah.
Are you on a rainbow or just all the colors?
I'm trying to do that.
That's nice.
Do you like to do art at school?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you get to do art in your classes very often? Or is it like a special occasion?
Very different feeling with quality from more traditional watercolor like that. Where some people really like, some people it's not for them, but they learn watercolor.
Would you like a bigger brush?
Yeah.
Alright. Here, try this one out. There you go. Mm-hmm. I can see you look like you like some coverage. So if you let that brush stay a little bit wet, it'll spread that color around really nicely.
Oh, perfect. Okay, thank you. The white is sort of like a pearl white.
Yeah. I think the name even that color might actually be
there will be a
stamp them and send them for you. Do you know anybody who lives far away that you think you might like to send your postcards to?
One of my cousins.
One of your cousins? Where do your cousins live?
One of my cousins lives in Alabama.
Really? That's pretty far. I've never been to Alabama. I'm gonna go to Missouri later this year, though, so that'll be cool.
What's going on in Missouri?
My friend's having her wedding.
Finally, or?
Yes, finally. They were gonna have it in October of last year.
Gotcha.
And then they postponed it to October of this year.
There you go.
Yeah, they were really lucky because their venue let them.
Oh, good.
You know,
just everything
just switch.
On hold.
Yeah. Ooh, that's very pretty. It's like a metallic rainbow sunset.
This is like not a rainbow
glitter. Yeah. Well, the fun thing is that you can make, when you make your own rainbow, you can have it be in whatever order that you like.
Like, I think that's sort of like a pale blue.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Yeah. Dry.
What do you tell Brent?
Thank you. What's your name? Zach. Nice to meet you, Zach. Oh, sorry, Pat. Nice to meet you.
It helps when you look. You have a mask on. You have to look at a person's face. Who are you going to send this to? For Masali? I don't know. Jazara?
I think Stella.
Stella's going to send it to Jazara. She's going all in.
Mm-hmm.
beautiful.
Thank you.
Yes? Mm-hmm. I carefully lift it. Right.
Well, enjoy the rest of art walk.
Thank you.
We yeah. Know. Thank you so much for painting with
Thanks.
Us.
Yes. Good job. Keep exploring, guys. You want to do a one jump short? Yeah, I've got this one, and I've got this weird flower situation happening. Not sure what I'm going to do with that. Sunflowers over there. I don't know. I'm not very good at doing watercolor backgrounds. I always like do the foreground first, and I'm like, oh no, I have to paint around it.
Oh,
too. Oh man, that would be so fun if you were here. You could give us like a gouache demo or something. Like, oh man, I can't wait till the border opens and you can come down. That'd be so cool. You have to come down when it's the third Thursday and we can do an art walk together. Oh man, that'd be awesome! Yeah! I heard they might be opening up the border in even just a couple of weeks. You ever just like figure out a cool technique and you're like, this is what I'm doing now. Hi, welcome to Art Spot. We could definitely go to Trader Joe's, we can go to the art store, could go to the, I know everybody up in Vancouver goes up to the outlet mall up by Bellingham, go there, that would be fun. Yeah. So I wonder what would happen now that I've got all this delicate little line work. What's gonna happen if I just moosh it all around, right? Kind of cool.
So, are all the colors shimmery like that?
Hello, welcome to Art Spot. Go ahead and put your mask on while you're inside.
Hi.
Go ahead and put your mask on while you're inside.
You gotta be kidding.
I am absolutely not. I see you have it right there in your hand.
I've been vaccinated.
Yeah, me too. Thank you. So what I'm doing is I'm doing demos for watercolor postcards if you would like to paint one.
You look familiar.
Yeah?
Well, take your mask down for a second.
No, absolutely not. But I work here. This is my mother's art store.
Tracy? Is
yeah.
Your mother?
Yeah, you Tracy's my mom.
You've got her eyes on.
Yeah.
I don't know about the smile, but you've got your...
Yeah.
Yeah, so I've taken classes from
her. That's awesome. Have you taken her encaustic class? Oh, acrylics. Yeah, those are so good.
So you're sponsoring that challenge? What was
yeah.
it? Is that still going on?
Yeah, it absolutely is. So this is the Paint by Postcard challenge. What we are challenging everybody to do is do 30 watercolor postcards over the course of the whole summer. When you sign up for our kit, you've got 30 postcards. You get a Kalinske Red Sable brush, which is a top-of-the-line watercolor brush. You get this sampler with 18 different Dan Smith watercolors in it. It comes with 3 postcard stamps to get you started. And we're encouraging everybody who's signing up to send postcards to each other, to their friends and family. Also, when you're signed up for the challenge, you get a 10% discount off of any ArtSpot purchase through the end of the whole summer.
All right.
So, yeah. Yeah, and we'll be continuing this through the whole summer. So it just gets harder and harder the longer you wait to sign up.
All right, well, we'll just kind of draw.
Yeah, enjoy looking around.
Yeah, there's your mom.
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, that's you.
Yeah, that's my.
You look just like
her. Yeah, it's kind of fun. Yeah, that's a coloring book I put together about 3 years ago now. So, yeah, it's all done. It's a collection of drawings I did of coral reefs, and we thought it would be fun to color. Hi, how's it going? Would you like to paint a watercolor postcard?
Oh, that could be fun.
Yeah. So, this is a watercolor postcard. It's a square of watercolor paper, and it's printed all ready to go with a stamp on the back. So yeah, here you are.
You guys should do that.
Does it cost money?
No, absolutely not. Yeah, and if you want to do a painting, and then if you leave your postcard here, we're gonna mail them out at the end of the night.
Oh, cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll leave our.
Yeah.
Can you choose who to mail them to?
Yeah. All the times if your postcard isn't completely dry, you can just write down a post-it note and we'll send them out at the end of the night.
And you can send them home if you want.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, or you can take it home with you.
I'm going to send it home because that's cool.
Yeah, I think you have to get it a couple of days. You guys have your address?
Yeah.
Okay.
How's it going?
I'm good. How are you? Are all the stores doing this?
A lot of the businesses are participating in Art Walk. So for us, we like to do a demo for it. Mm-hmm. But a lot of the different stores have a featured artist, and they have their workout.
That's
and
fun.
Open a little bit later. So yeah, really, really cool.
What's happening here?
There's like other stores that are doing like art walk.
Yeah. So every third Thursday of the month is Art Walk, which means that all the businesses stay open late and that we are featuring different artists.
Maybe the toy store is open then.
They might be. Yeah, I don't know if they're participating or not, but it's easy enough to walk by and see if it's open.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if you take your wet paintbrush, you can get some really pretty gradient effects.
Okay, I'm gonna draw this.
What are you making, Tom? Something like
that? No. I'm making a smiley face.
Ooh, that'll be cool. So one of the things that's really cool about watercolors is that unlike acrylic or oil paint, you can just paint really, really thin layers. So you get lots and lots of water on your brush like this. And then see how this paint here is like kind of thick? You wanna let it be really thin. And then you can let the light from the paper shine through.
Oh, wow, yeah.
See how you have your paint really thick right there? If you wanted to, you could take a wet paintbrush and work it around, and you could get some really lovely kind of see-through techniques. Because if you notice here, I don't have any white paint out, and that's because you left the white from the paper shine through.
So where is
One thing that's cool about watercolor is even after it's really, really dry like this, you can still take a little bit of water and it'll wake up. It's called reconstituting.
How can you use this?
Where I did place it, I could not see it any longer.
So. Thank you.
super stable.
That, I like that color.
Yeah, it's kind of like a bronzy kind of color.
Is that a video?
Yeah, so what I'm doing is I'm actually live streaming on our Facebook page. So if there's anybody who can't come down to Edmonds to visit, then they can watch online and follow along.
They said so satisfying.
So, yeah, that's pretty fun. And also it gives us a fun, like, record of what we did. So mm-hmm. we post them on YouTube later. They end up being, like, an hour and a half or however long. So if people want to be like, oh, what did I miss out on for the demo or whatever, then they have a chance to see. I feel like mine is feeling kind of beachy.
Yeah, I like it. I feel like it's a postcard you could get at, like... Like, I think it's when, like, professionally bought it. They didn't make it.
That's one of the things that's really fun about watercolors is you can paint, like, abstract things, mm-hmm. or you can paint, like, really... I mean, like, I always have an easier time painting abstract things because I'm not very good at watercolor. But there are some really talented artists who have just, you know, practice and practice mm-hmm. and practice and can just get the most amazing effects with, like, light and shadow. Kind of like mine. I'm like, I don't want to mess this up, but I'm gonna keep going. Why not?
This is so good, though.
Thank you.
You're really able to match the colors well.
Oh, yeah. That's cool. Thanks. I'm gonna see if I can write something in the middle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I have all these different pens here. I would just make sure that you don't write over where the paint is wet.
Yeah, just, I'm going to write it in the middle.
Yeah, that's going to look really cool.
Thank you.
On yours, Tom? Do you want black?
I need a quote to write.
What kind of quote do you want?
I just want something that's really short, like this. It's like, be you, but not be you.
Not be you. You want to look some up?
Hi, welcome to our spot.
Hello, thank you.
What are you writing, Tom?
You should have a tag.
Where is your
Yeah, probably.
Oh, that's Nora. Nora runs the art block. She is organizes everything.
Yes, she is important. Yeah. I'm Tom. Who's it to? You want to mail it to your parents? Yeah. To Tom. Okay.
So we have these as individual semi-moist watercolors over in our watercolor section.
Oh, really?
But yeah, I definitely have a weakness for like shimmery things right now. So I'm like, I'm gonna put out like the shimmery. These ones, the shimmery ones.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's just like sometimes it's fun just to make things a little bit sparkly.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Oh, I do it all the time.
Mm-hmm. I know. We were fun. Because when we were hanging up like our little playground up there, I know we were running into a lot of issues in the city about like how those things sign.
Oh, yeah.
So
that's true.
Last month when we were putting this up for the first time, like
Oh, I like that. What a good message.
Okay, I wanna. Can I write the address?
Mm-hmm, yeah, let me go grab a post-it note.
Do you want to take yours, Tom, or do you want to mail it?
I'm
mailing it. Do the art? Okay.
Great idea.
Oh, so
Yeah, these just were invented very recently. We're gonna start carrying them at our store because we had
the what was this invented?
These metallic pens. They just came out. So some art supplies are very, very old.
Yeah.
I can look up.
Oh, cute.
So good.
Thank you.
Yes.
You're going for our ball.
Yay!
Yes, I did.
That's awesome. I think this is only like the third one this year.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So super happy to have those back up in business.
Yeah. Have you been getting a lot of people doing the watercolor postcard?
You know, mostly kids are the only ones who are brave enough to do, to do a watercolor.
Yeah, you told me as we were walking in, like, I can't do that.
Well, yes, you can.
Oh, I mean,
you can.
Well, I just did one that looks like this. It's just stripes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
These I think they're all good.
Yeah.
I will do one.
Yeah?
Can you do one with me? See if we can get other adults
there
to do it.
There you are. Let's show these kids what's up.
Yeah.
That means I can also bust out my ground of watercolors.
Oh, fun. Oh, wow.
Yeah, so these are Dan Smith watercolors, which is a top-of-the-line color house that's actually located right here in Seattle.
Huh.
I don't know, lately I've just been having a lot of fun with their metallics.
Yeah.
These are all brushes you can use. Okay. You can grab a new one, depending on what you like.
Okay.
Yeah, there's no right or wrong answer.
Right.
You know?
Just go.
Yeah. And if you want to take your postcard home with you, you're fully welcome to, but if you leave it here, we can mail it for you.
Oh, maybe I should put the address first.
Oh, that's a good idea. That's what I brought my post-it notes because I realized that, like, you can't flip it over when it's still wet. It's a partially formed idea.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We're like, is our nap happening this month? Okay, it is. Okay, let's go do this. This will be fun. So we've decided that June is watercolor month here at Art Spa.
Oh, okay.
And so we have like some watercolor sales going on. We're hosting a watercolor postcard challenge. So tonight everything is free to play. It's just, you know, fun and it's good to get people thinking.
Mm-hmm. It's been so long, I don't know what to do.
I mean, creativity is just so necessary. And
absolutely.
I've been bottled up for a year now.
Yeah. And also just like, low pressure creativity.
Yes.
Where you're just like, I'm just going to do something for fun. And if it turns out terrible, I don't have to show anybody.
Yeah. Or I can just mail it to someone I don't like.
Yeah, you know, you don't have to send it to your friends. You can send it to your enemies as well.
Yeah. Be like, what I think of you. Bad art.
Like, you deserve bad art, you know? Some of my friends, started doing an art project, and they like doing like puppetry, but they had a puppet, and they were sending the puppet from, like, it was like a almost like telephone.
Okay.
But like one person would like, you know, add the eyes, and the next person would like add the ears, and like another person would, and it turned into this like funny looking monkey monster thing. I don't even know how to describe it, but I would love to see what it started out as, and then how it ended up.
I love the concept.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, these are, this is pretty.
Yeah, these are the Daniel Smith, like, duo
chrome
line is the name that they call their, like, early metallics. I recently found out that Daniel Smith, because it's such an established color house, they actually own the mines where the pigments are mined out of. So they can, like, basically, like, grind it up, so it's like, you get, like, really cool effects with, how shiny it can be, and like how the size of the minerals and stuff like that. It's so fascinating. It's like
really fascinating.
Way above my pay grade stuff, but like just really, really neat.
And you said what's his name?
Oh, they're called Daniel Smith. The tubes look like this.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah. Huh.
My liability. Are we getting the same one?
No, you guys kind of have like similar colors.
We'll see what she ends up doing with hers, though. Mine's got a plan.
Oh, I know, I don't really know. No, I'm not worried about it.
Nor should you.
This is the one that I did when I had no plan. I was like squishing out the colors.
Fun.
And then I was like, oh, I have all these colors like on my brush. And I was like, squish. And I was just like, okay, that's
fun.
It's a party postcard, I guess.
A little bit of everything.
Yeah.
Like a lot of red. I don't want to sound like,
Yeah, I love doing fun things at gatherings with people.
Yeah.
Tie dye.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I have some screens for screen printing and like a little DIY setup.
Oh, that's cool. I got to take a screen printing class when I was in college, and it was, I liked it so much I took screen printing 1 and 2. Which is like a big deal for me because like I had transferred in a bunch of credits from like when I was in high school, so like I went into college and they're like, you get to take 2 electives the entire time you're here.
You're like, wait.
And I was like, wait, what? But they were, I ended up doing them both as screen printing. So fun. Really liked it.
Were you doing on paper or on cloth?
I was doing mostly paper prints, but I did do a print of, I made a print of an octopus on my backpack. That was my backpack. I still have it. I still think it's cool.
Oh, that's awesome.
It hasn't lost it.
A little bit of the detail is like kind of faded away, but you can still tell what it is.
Nice.
Yeah. Fun.
Yeah, and it was like literally the very first product, so it wasn't like that good of a print to begin with. It was like a little like blotchy, but you know, I still like it.
Yeah. So. Well, it gives it that street feel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had that was the backpack that like I had all through college, and I took it all around the world with me and stuff like that.
Awesome.
So yeah.
Yeah, I had taken the like course training thing to use the Vera project down at the Science Center.
Oh, cool.
Screen printing, and then COVID hit. And I was like, this awesome professional setup that is like at my fingertips now, and I can't do anything.
Yeah. Well, that was one of the reasons why I like wasn't able to continue doing screen printing, because I like couldn't figure out how to do like the emulsion and stuff like that, and like the where it has like the white suction table where you like burn in your screen, and it's like, how on earth do you do that if you like don't have the setup? Like, people always talk about like basement like screen printing, and I'm like, I literally like don't understand how that works. I'm like, but you need the whole thing, right? Like, it's like a big piece of equipment,
right?
Well, I was able to somehow make it happen in the basement and set up screens and screen print like out in the back patio and party.
Oh, that's awesome. That's so cool.
That was fun.
Yeah. I was studying animation in college. So, like, animation is, you know, you spend, you know, 10,000 hours and you get, like, a 30-second video.
Uh-huh.
And so, like, I love screen printing because I could, like, you know, I could, you know, get 10,000 prints in 30 seconds. Yeah. I was like, this is great. Like, I thought that was really fun.
Why didn't I know this before?
Yeah. Well, it's just like really just producing a volume of art was very satisfying after. That's just not the nature of the beast when it comes to animation.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have some friends that have done like claymation, and that is like hours of monotony, it feels like.
Yeah, that's actually what I specialized in.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I, up until a year or two ago, I did the hair for the puppets for stop motion animation.
So it was
like super specific.
Huh.
But yeah, I used to work on stop motion animation TV shows down in Los Angeles.
Oh wow.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, my very last show just came out last month before I moved out here. If you ever see it on Hulu, it's called Marvel's MODOK.
Marvel's MODOK.
I would not say it's safe for kids. It's a grown-up TV show.
Well, maybe you can watch it if I'm there.
All right. I'll cover your eyes in the parts that need to be covered.
But it was a really fun project.
That's awesome.
What brought you up here? Are you from?
Yeah, I actually grew up here in Edmonds, and this is actually my family store.
Oh, awesome. Okay.
Yeah.
Welcome home.
Thank you.
Hi,
good to
see
you, Julie.
Would you like to paint a postcard?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So fun. Art walk must be like a totally different thing for you, though.
Yeah, it is. Like, my mom started this store when I was living in California in college at the time, so this is my first time I've gotten to, like, be home and, like, work here full time and all that kind of stuff. So it's been really nice.
Hi.
Yeah, I really liked Los Angeles a lot, but it wasn't a place I wanted to settle down.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, I'd like to buy a house one day. That's never going to happen down here.
Yeah.
But it's really cool. It's a really cool city. A lot of opportunities down there. Although, like, my friends used to live down there, like, texted me, it's like 108.
Like, it's going to be 68 today.
Yeah,
it's
like,
too hot.
Do you want to come up here and like, spend the 4th of July with me? Like, I like your sunset. That's
cool. Oh, thanks.
It's like all golden. I like that.
The colors are
yeah, that's one of the things that you can really start to see the difference between, like, these are the ones over here are the high-quality paints, and these are, like, the, like, student entry paints. And there's, like, the main difference is with any kind of paint between, like, you know, inexpensive paint and, like, top-of-the-line stuff is literally the density of pigment. Like, there's literally more color in this than there is in
that
this.
Makes sense.
And that's what you're painting.
Got it.
And so it's interesting because it's like, depending on the scale of your work, like this can actually end up being, it's more of an upfront cost, but you actually get
more
color.
Got it.
Yeah, and you can stretch that color out further as well. I just think of it kind of like soup. Like, this is like really good homemade soup, and then this is like
stuff from the
yeah, which is good.
Right,
you know?
Right. Just depends on what you're after.
Yeah, it just depends on what you're looking for
now. We've been doing art projects and stuff and not done too much play creativity, which I've been feeling that actually the last couple of days.
Yeah. Well,
so,
this is a good day,
good
day to come out and try something new.
Yeah. Thank you for not treating us like kids or treating us like kids.
Well, it's like we were able to buy a house, and so I've been doing nonstop house stuff for the past 2 weeks. Like,
you know how it is.
You need it too.
Yes, this is really nice. Like, I'm like, we no longer have popcorn ceiling. It's really exciting. Like, all the everything's been painted. Like, I don't know when it was painted yet last, but I think it might have been like multiple decades.
Oh, wow.
So. Yeah. Oh, those are both really pretty.
Yeah, thank you.
If you
want
to take them with you, or if you leave them here, I will mail them out tomorrow.
Okay.
I will leave mine here.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
No, I have like a drying rack.
Perfect. Oh, thanks.
Awesome.
Oh, fun. Thank
you.
So that was awesome.
Yeah.
Thank
have
you.
A wonderful day.
Thanks, you too.
You.
want to say to you is that, remember when I told you that I had friends that I thought you guys would really connect with?
Yeah, the ones on Whidbey Island.
So I just was, we just spent a couple days with them, and it just dawned on me when I told, well, first off, I said to him, you know, got some people I want you to meet, theater, puppetry, animation, and then
VR.
And he goes, oh, my kind of people.
Yes.
Well, he used to be your dad's, one of your dad's employees.
Really?
And I don't know what your relationship is with your father, if you see him much.
Yeah, well, I'm going to see him Sunday for Father's Day.
Okay, for Father's Day, you're going to say, I want to meet Eric Klein and his wife.
Oh,
and
I
you
know
are
going to
make
Klein.
This happen. It's Eric and Danielle Klein.
Yeah.
And so that, we're going to make
I don't
this,
know them well, but
it would happen. It might happen through your dad.
Yeah.
Sooner than it would maybe with me trying to figure out how to make it happen.
Mm-hmm.
And if it doesn't, then I will make it happen.
Yeah.
Okay, because they are so creative and kind and. But it's
Eric.
It's just.
World.
I know. But he's. They're all of that. So. So there you go. Yes, it is a small world. And when I said that, I was just like, oh, it's Tracy's. He was like, oh, how's, what's your dad's name?
Rick.
I haven't seen Rick in a long time. I'm like, he goes, I'll call him up. You know, so he kind of acted like he would try to make it happen. So if it's coming from both sides, then
oh, that'd be
then
awesome.
Happen.
Yeah.
Okay.
My dad would be like over the moon. He loves like hanging out with all of his old work
oh,
buddies.
Oh, good. Okay, well, there you go. Where does he live?
He's actually just moving down to Wallingford.
Okay. Okay, so what are we doing? Just having fun?
Just having fun. So these are the grown-up watercolors.
Yeah, send it to...
These are the kids' watercolors. I suggest that you put your address on, or whoever address that you'd like to send it to first. Because if it's wet, then you can't flip it over. But I have figured out to bring over some Post-it notes.
Very smart.
For just such an occasion, if necessary.
So which are the grown ones?
These three here. So these are all Daniel Smith colors. And that just means that they have, it's a higher quality paint. So there's actually more color. There's more pigment in the paint than with the student grade.
And I'm Pam.
Oh, hi. Okay. It's nice to meet you. I'm Bryn.
What's your name?
Bryn. Yeah, I'm Tracy's daughter.
I'm Julie Smith. I'm from my mom.
Yeah,
really?
Visiting.
That's cool.
Something. Oh, well, I just put an O here. Like it's
Edmonds.
I know.
Edmonds,
it's
Washington.
I like that. She said Oklahoma, and I just like.
Yeah, I definitely like put out all the sparkly ones. What is this for? It's a resiliency. Yeah, I've just been doing just. Almost like kind of just like, well, mostly I've been using paint that's like left on the brushes to like some random stuff.
There you go.
Yeah, so it doesn't have to be anything.
So this stuff is the pearlescent that looks good on top of. I like to just put regular paint and then put that on top. Right?
Yeah.
That's scary.
I'm making a lot of mine just be with paints, and I'm like cleaning up. Okay, so like this Daniel Smith paint is like is on the pricier side, and I opened it up, the yellow up, and it went, and it like went all over, so I had to like sweep it up. Not sweep, but like scoop it.
Yeah, thank you for that.
I love your hair.
Thank you.
All of my kids have different. Types of red hair.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god, there was these two little kids who were in earlier, they did postcards, but they were both like super, super red hair like mine.
Yeah.
And I was just like, yay, look! Wow. I played it cool. I don't see other redheads very often. There's like two of them right
now. I know. It's like, what, you know, you gotta get excited about it because they might go away someday.
Yeah.
I don't want them to, so.
Yeah. All right.
Sam's girlfriend has reddish hair.
And
she
yeah.
Oh,
brilliant. That's a good thing. May I also take a picture of my favorite hand so I can throw the idea in the content?
Sure, absolutely.
Yeah, for sure.
Thank you.
You can get our face too. Can you see me smiling?
I can.
Hello.
I see the eyes.
Hi, Rachel.
Hello.
Rachel Dobbins, right?
Rachel Dobbins.
Right. That's
yes,
me.
I know you.
I was
going to
take my mask off.
I know. So we've been unmasked together.
And it's like so
fun. I love that we've been on last.
That's not what he's meant to have a confession.
It means we're close.
I might not want to know about.
She's in my circle, yeah. My bubble.
It's good to have a bubble.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, we're kind of in the wider bubble. We weren't in the little skinny bubble first. But
the skinny bubble.
But we are in our little widening, our circle bubble.
Okay, so Mary said that she was going to have like a little barbecue thing last Friday, and I ended up working until like 8. But
you know, I didn't go. She said it was fun. It was like kind of crappy out, and they just did it underneath the thing. She said it was kind of fun. So I did talk to her. She was having a baby shower. Because I met with Mike down there on Sunday, just because he hadn't seen it in a while. And we need to, like, the sinks are in, but the mirrors aren't, but then the tiles will be ready before we know it. And he's kind of going out of town, and so I wanted to make sure that he was on board and everything. But I think we'll be able to talk with her and kind of make some plans at the 1st of July. She said that won't be too late. But I know sometimes she'll just go, okay, we're going to do the tiles tomorrow.
You're like, that's pretty. Like a
I always
thing.
Take my fingers in there.
My new favorite thing is the octopus bowl.
The what?
The octopus bowl that you made and James came and got me.
Oh, yes. What about it?
Like a restaurant.
Yeah.
So octopuses are really getting a lot of attention.
They right are. Right. Have you seen that movie on Netflix?
Yeah. My octopus
so
teacher.
Sweet. Yeah.
And I just listened to the audiobook of The Soul of an Octopus.
I haven't heard of that
you
one.
Should switch.
You know what? We just went to Whidbey Island and stayed in a hotel. They had like 5,482 mermaid things.
I like mermaids, but I think
but
I've had my dose.
A little bit.
I think I've been dosed for my life.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The last thing, I got her to put on a mermaid crocheted blanket bottom thing today and lay back and while she was drinking.
Oh, I have
coffee.
One of those.
See?
I do too.
My uncle got it for me.
It's a very affordable situation. 3-bedroom house on Whidbey, and you look back, kind of across back over at Edmonds. Oh, you're over. Bren just bought a house on the over
yeah,
across
just,
the Kingston.
Yeah, I just bought a house in Paulsboro.
Oh, in Paulsboro, okay.
Mm-hmm.
She knows Paulsboro because we drove through there once to
visit. Oh, cool. Yeah, only about like, I don't know, like a mile and a half outside of downtown Paulsboro at this point.
So Camille's boyfriend is going to start working at a kind of a pizza, Italian pizza place over there that's just right off.
Ooh.
She said it's off the ferry in the first building on the left, and they're just
kind of
opening.
Oh, is it
Willie's? Yeah.
Their pizza's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm considering.
It's funny because it's like, Kingston, there's like 5 buildings there, and 3 of them are pizza places.
They are.
Like,
oh my god, it's like, what? We have too much pizza going on, don't we?
No.
We never have too much.
I kind of feel like
we
never.
Yeah, but like, hi, welcome to our spot. Yeah, it's, we've eaten at Sardo Willis and we've eaten at the one across the street, which is, West Side Pizza.
West Side. Oh, okay, there you go.
I love going to Bryn's house so much that I'm like, we're going to buy a house over there next.
Oh, really?
You know, and we just moved into a house like that.
She just locked out and got a really nice house. Before it all ended. So what's that?
So those are metallics. Those are the semi-most metallics.
Right, and so you're saying that these are the ones you're getting out of the jar. Let me show you where you get those.
Yeah, these ones here, like, are...
okay, so that's kind of what I bought when I took that lady's class.
Yeah.
And then these are what I bought when I taught the senior citizens.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
But they're not bad, and you know.
No, these are actually pretty good.
Yeah, but these I have to learn about more.
Yeah, these ones are just highly pigmented, so they're really good, especially if you get interested in color mixing.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I have found that the Daniel Smith iridescents, like all of their shiny ones, are like so shiny, and they're also like more.
These are the Daniel Smith.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they're giving us postcards to send
yeah.
to yourself. You could send one, a really sweet message to yourself because you probably deserve it.
I do today.
Mine is today. You can do it. We can do this. We're
my creative expression.
I like it. It's pretty.
I don't know what it is, but
it's like fireworks.
Yeah, it is.
Or like flowers. I can't tell.
Or the water, or you know, it could be a little of everything.
It's perfect.
Did you adjust it?
I did.
Mm-hmm. I'm sending it to me.
Good for you.
He's on vacation. It would be
good. Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
this would be fun.
It's on my dog. Look at what
that one needs a lot of water.
This one. I might have put dirty water in it.
No, it's fine. We're all too mixing stuff.
So, you know, I gave the paints to the kiddos at Chase Lake in their little teeny paintbrush. Yeah. Remember that we had our little deal? And I would tell them about this shop down here and how they helped us do this. And, you know, thinking maybe someday they'll walk in here and say something about it. Mm-hmm. Second graders. And then I taught them about mixing colors and
primary. I looked at the images that you posted. They're very
primary. And, well, the robot thing was just me and the teacher. I didn't put any of theirs on there. It's so hard. They're in this Zoom class, and then I try to take it. And then if their face is in it, I have to blur their face out.
Yeah.
And then, but
well,
you know what I noticed?
Spent 5 hours on the computer.
Yeah, but you know what I noticed was the teacher when I was teaching them. Like, I look up at the screen, and she's like this. Mm-hmm. She never looked up to see what her kids were doing. She was just like this. And I was like, oh, I see your teacher's really into this. Let's see what you did. And she just kind of held it up and smiled real big and put it back down and like, bye-bye. And the kids were all online learners. They're not in person. So they kind of have it down, you know. And I taught them how to say their name because they'd say, Miss Julie, blah, blah, blah. You know, and I'm like, who's talking? So then they'd say, hey, Miss Julie, it's Leo. Blah, 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 blah. You know,
that's smart.
Yeah. So I had them draw. I had them paint a robot last week, and apparently a couple of the boys in their little class meeting talked about how on the weekend they made robots with things around the house.
That's cool.
They kept, you know, they went on and made three dimensional robots.
Hi, Whitney.
Hi.
Are you my love?
Mwah,
mwah.
Yay.
Hi, Whitney.
Would you like to paint a postcard?
To paint a postcard.
So the first step is to address it on the other side, so it'll get you. Then we'll mail it out tomorrow.
Who are we mailing it to?
Well, whoever you address it to.
Yourself, your friends, your family.
Did you address yours to?
I did, to my house, but to Camille.
Aww.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
Just having fun. I'm going to go see Shannon. She's over at Pro. So I figured I'd make it to my favorite
spot. If you're having a class, is it this weekend?
It's the 26th.
So the whole thing is we're trying to post other community instructors' classes. So, but you'd have to send us the information so we can post it.
Oh, okay. I will.
Maybe also they dropped off little flyers for us.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yes. Meredith just made them up, and I just posted them. So I'll send it to you via Facebook and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
She just sent it.
Yeah, we'll just copy and paste.
I will be doing better at being more on top of things. We did this whole little funny thing over the week for about the last week. Almost bought a house.
Really?
No way.
Where at?
Edmonds, about 5 minutes from where we're at.
Nice.
But that's where you've been looking.
Yeah, much bigger studio space. Yay. However, we were willing to bid over the asking price, but we did not get it because somebody else bid over the asking price.
Oh, come in.
By how much?
You guess.
$100,000.
You can send yourself a little note.
$75,000.
Tell yourself how great you're doing.
$361,000 over the asking price.
Really? Dang.
And we didn't get it. Imagine that. Oh, my gosh. We just went, whatever.
Yeah.
Can you?
Dang.
That little
almost done. If you want to step in here, just stop some time.
Awesome. Thank you.
Dang.
That's insane. I thought we got outbid by. It was a $475,000 house, and it sold for $625,000, and we thought that was bad.
Oh my gosh! It makes you just want to go. Why even try?
Yeah, you're like, who are these people?
Thank you, ladies.
Thank
good to see you.
You.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you. Have
glad
fun in the Great Northwest.
Thanks.
Bye.
Have fun.
You too. I'm doing Jordan because I know the address by heart. He's with us.
There you go.
Tim, you want to send a postcard to your mom and dad?
Oh, dude, you know that, mom.
Did you already design one?
Yeah. You do the address first.
I do have some pre-colored ones for people who are... Ooh. But you know how they're...
I like that, though. Yeah.
You don't get one because you know how to draw.
He's really good at drawing.
Do I have to do one?
Yeah, I'll do one.
Hey,
I think yeah, you do.
Do I have to? If you say that you open yourself up to three women saying, yeah.
I should do something. Where's Mason?
Oh, behind the counter.
Okay, can you do some kind of groovy... For a gamer, I'm like, I could do flowers or something. Jordan's going to be like, really, what's the point? Okay, gamer painter.
Oh, no.
I'm like, yeah, I got nothing. Oh, he's just going to get flowers because I don't know what else to do.
You know, flowers are like OG groovy.
Okay,
no,
I like that. Well, you know, he'll be happy. Anything... You know, my mom's nice. Okay, and I
would you like to paint
a
postcard?
That just will tomorrow. Turn into a butterfly. Oh, this is that cool metallic.
Let me think about it.
Sure. Yeah.
She's looking a little in the neck.
You left me.
Yeah.
Is there a black?
A black pen? Yes, there is. This is a black pen.
Is it thicker?
This is the thickest one.
I'm going to let this dry, and I'm going to go in with these. These are a brand new product that has just come out. There are metallic...
with the...
Silo pens. Yes. And I think that they show up really well on glass, which is very good.
It's an abstract.
You were doing perfectly fine before I got here.
Yeah.
I was gonna do. I was going to do a flower, but I was talking and I wasn't paying attention, and it was not flower shaped, so it turned into a butterfly.
Closely related. So, do you want to see my favorite app in the world? I just started it yesterday. Because you can do two things at once.
I can do.
It's called Blenduku. It's this. But it's because we're Glen. And, when you start it, you start at a simple level, and basically there's your colors that you organize.
We want to do the postcard.
I'll just do it. Okay. So you just
would like to do a postcard?
Oh, this is the darkest.
Yeah.
This is the next darkest available.
Yeah. I think there'll be room shortly.
Okay. But then when you get to an advanced level, you're looking at like... almost like it looks like a crossword puzzle.
Right.
And you have to figure out the logic of how the colors flow.
Oh, how fun.
And it's so fascinating.
Hi, hey. How's it going?
Hello. How are you?
Good.
Hey, she's stalking us.
Oh, yeah, I know I am.
Anyway, I'm going to send it to you. I think you'll like it.
I love it.
I might go down and set up another
table.
Yeah,
so
that would be
nice. I have
a feeling
these are just
beautiful. So we're inviting people to paint a postcard. If you pre-address it and leave it with us, we'll mail it out for you tomorrow.
Oh, so sweet.
And
I actually didn't. I'm on my way home. I've been gone all day.
Yeah.
But I ran into. I don't know. Julie is.
Julie Crean?
Yeah, she's on my walk route.
Yeah.
And she came out the other day, the same time we were walking by, and she said something about, ooh, look at those gorgeous colors. Graphite.
Uh-huh.
And the studios.
Yeah.
So do you have any idea when you're going to have any idea?
Right now we know we have
six studios.
Uh-huh.
And they're not going to be like super economy or anything. They're going to be
high end.
They're pretty high end.
Okay.
But because we're going to use the ones that are rented out to subsidize one that will be for bringing in like a student intern program.
Uh-huh.
So we'll always have people maybe, this is all still hypothetical.
Oh yeah, no, there's a ways to go.
Yeah, there's going to be a whole room full of lockers, and you can rent a locker and keep your art supplies and come anytime you want and use the workshop with you.
Really?
It's sort of like the art spot.
Art spot, yeah. Oh, that's good to know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's got a library of art books.
Uh-huh.
It's going to have a restaurant and it has a gallery.
Yes.
So now that the building's up, it's more real, you know?
Yeah, I know. It's always been, you know, kind of like, okay, when is it ever going to happen?
Yeah, like a hypothetical idea.
Okay, well, I've been gone all day. I need to go home.
Okay.
Good to see you.
Pour yourself a glass of wine or a cup of tea. And
yeah, just relax.
Yes. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
I know it's just cold again.
Yeah, I've got classes set up for this fall.
Has Mason contacted you yet?
He did, but we didn't have anything. I mean, it's not until September.
Well, let us know when you have your class description and
okay.
You have your supply list.
Mm-hmm.
We are not working directly with Cole as far as, we're working directly with the instructors at this point. So
okay.
As soon as the class is open to the, checking registration, mm-hmm. Let us know when it's on our website.
Okay.
There'll be a link to your class on our website.
Okay. Perfect.
Yeah.
All
so
right.
That might help you to fill your classes in. Anyway, we're just trying to help instructors get
well, you guys are doing so good. You're doing good.
Thank you.
Yeah. And it's nice to have your kids here.
Rinse downstairs getting another table.
Oh.
So more people can paint.
Cool. All right. It's good to see you. Take care.
Lovely.
See you guys.
Because, yeah, that was a fan Mason. I mean, I'm
loving
it.
Oh, shit.
That one was so nice. I remember
when I don't feed me. I think I should just set it up right over there. Okay. They move? Yeah.
Oh my.
Hello. Would you like to paint a postcard?
Not today.
We're setting up a new station. Yeah, if people paint a postcard, we'll mail it out tomorrow for you.
This is what we squid though.
Ellen and Tracy. Ellen and Tracy. I will do one for Al, but I already have one.
Are we ready? Oh, okay. Say okay.
Okay. Let me grab a selection of artsy materials.
No, this one's like a
so we are doing a watercolor postcard.
I forgot to write anything, I just put the address.
Okay.
So I can do
what painting?
Oh, okay.
Black didn't work.
Yeah.
Having fun and not really.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, that's how I ended up with all the ones that look like
puzzles. Those are good though. I like those.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. But I don't think that's the end of the world, you know. It'll be
Yeah.
No,
I'm sure
Jordan.
And it just happens that we saw
He'll just read it and go, Mom, why didn't you... I didn't write anything yet. Whoops.
Oh.
I got it addressed. So I'll have to do something, but,
There's people on. That was a message from Mayor from a little while ago.
Oh, that's your friend from Canada.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ming's
awesome.
I don't know if you guys saw this, but,
When was the last time you painted something,
Jim? Actually painted?
Yeah.
Like a painting?
It's like you just painted a paint right now.
Yeah, it would have been, it's probably been, I guess I was painting before we got married. I don't know if I painted before we got, since we got married.
I'm not sure we have. You, I have.
Bags of watercolors because this one is like it's a lot of red, it's a lot of perilene red, and it's a lot of the sparkly colors.
Oh,
there wasn't like a normal
mix. So, actually, truly, these ones actually just on the downside.
Oh, they do
know
great.
What
binding around. Oh, so they don't have that
too much
peripheral.
Oh, okay. That'll always break and then you'll have to.
It brings such good energy into the space.
I love it.
I know.
I love your mom's attitude.
Yeah.
And yours.
And everybody has a little bit more
approach. Oh, I love that spot. Mom, I think I'm going to sleep in the back of the
We are live on Facebook right now. If you want to see what's happening in our blog, you can try to look at the drive.
I don't always recognize people.
I know, right?
Janice. That was Janice Graves.
Oh, well, no, that, I knew Janice. Uh-huh. Someone else came by and said, oh, wait, Janice. I was like, oh, sure.
One time Lynette Henley came in the store, and she had a hat and glasses and a mask, and I literally couldn't see anything much more than just like a little
table. And did you know who it was?
No, and I said, she's saying hi and everything, and I'm like, hi, and she goes, you know, like talking to me like she knows me, which she does, but I said, you really have to tell me who you are, because I can't gather for you to know it's you. One of those just COVID things.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There's certainly giving us a huge.
Yeah.
Just a little. So it was really neat. Ron and Angela were showing.
There's a pretty good crowd over at Cole.
Yeah. Although there's a pretty good crowd here too. So. Jordan's going to be like, Mom?
Well, you are a mom, so you can do mom-ish things. Hi, would you like to paint a postcard?
I am thinking about doing it.
Yeah. If you, address it before you paint on it, then we're going to send them all out tomorrow, so we'll mail it for you.
Oh!
A couple have been painted that haven't been addressed, and we're doing a watercolor postcard challenge to kind of just encourage some camaraderie and make something fun in the mail. But we'll just pull a few names out of the community bucket of the postcard artists and see if send them out randomly. Hello.
Hi. Mm-hmm. Is Edmonds in your phone? Not in my phone. I have my brother.
So we generally
have remember in the old days when we used to memorize people's phone numbers?
Yeah. Oh, I know, and that was easy.
I still remember how my parents' even phone number, you know, that I grew up with.
So these micron pens would all be a good choice to address it. And and if you want to draw something in with a pen and then color it in with watercolor or however you want to do it.
All right, there you go.
Yay.
Not my best work, but, you know, it's a postcard. He'll be happy.
When was the last time you got some fun in the mail?
Right?
Saying, yeah.
Although I get fun mail a lot. I've been making handmade cards for people in retirement homes, and they always send me beautiful thank you notes, and some have sent me gifts, and oh my gosh, they have just been too much. They have been really, really sweet, but I have had a blast. That was how I fought COVID.
Doing good things for others.
Well, it helps.
Yeah.
That was my life raft.
Oh, this
one. Hi, darling.
And see you tomorrow at 7.
Tomorrow night at 7. Did I tell you?
What's tomorrow night?
We're going over to her house.
I just texted James and let him know, and he's like, okay. Great, sounds great. And I'm like, I'm with the right guy.
It's in my calendar. Yeah. You can stay on my good side
and over here. He can be casual, spontaneous.
Yeah, I think we oftentimes think about postcards just when we're on vacation.
Yeah, and then I've often carry around a little address book with me then.
Yeah.
You know, but.
But of course not today, since you're giving me the address.
Yeah.
I'm a big believer in Murphy. It's one of those Murphy's Law things.
Yeah.
You have something every day until you need it.
Right.
Have you ever done watercolor before?
Not seriously. I mean, as a kid, you know.
Okay.
No, not much.
On that table over there, I have watercolor markers, and they look just like a marker. And you can touch them with water after you draw your picture, and it'll kind of melt them a little bit. That's kind of fun. Yeah. Would you like to do a piece of art?
Oh, come on. You got me to do it, and then you didn't do it.
There's a few that have not been addressed, and we're just going to send them out from addresses we have in our community bucket. So that's a good thing to do. I'm having fun with these pearly colors.
Oh yeah, that, that.
Around the store we call it bling.
Yeah.
Lots of people like adding touches of metallics. That's actually just a, something I do for display, but I bought those at the Cezanne studio in Aix, France.
Okay.
And I brought them back. So even when I'm on vacation, I still buy things at the store.
Nobody cares.
Are you going to go out to dinner?
We're thinking about it.
This, usually they have maps printed out. I don't know if they're doing that right now during COVID, but it'll sometimes list restaurants that are doing discounts.
If no, you, they didn't do it.
They didn't do that this time. Would you like to paint a postcard tomorrow?
I think I'm going to pass it. We're just walking through it. It looks fun.
Children in the store, and they haven't been vaccinated yet, so it's just to keep them as safe as we can. Hard to get in here too.
Oh, yeah.
We inherited this very lumpy entryway. Challenge where you we have I think about 50 artists so far that have joined the challenge, and they're all going to be mailing watercolor postcards to each other and painting all summer long. It's a kit that includes all the supplies you need, and then you can be like part of the community bucket.
I think I'll pass.
We've been doing drawing challenges and acrylic painting challenges, and it finally occurred to us that we should be doing a watercolor challenge. And a lot of people really want to do that.
Okay, that's it.
Okay.
You're going to mail it for me.
We will. We'll mail it out tomorrow.
Yeah. I'm holding.
My brother's an artist.
Oh, wonderful. Well, he'll have a good mail day.
Anything like what he would do.
Well, thanks for,
okay,
thank you.
Thanks for being a good sport.
I better
give
you that back.
Sure.
Well, hope to see you again sometime.
Nice.
Isn't that pretty?
Yeah, that's a really good one.
Yeah. All right. Thanks.
Bye. Happy art walk. So these will all get mailed out tomorrow. Well, let me get a group shot of you all with your postcards, and then I'll take them up for you.
We have to show our art.
Yes, we do.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Got it.
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for letting us do this, and thanks for sending them out.
Absolutely. We have a little table up just behind the counter there if you want to try them up there.
Oh, that's cool.
Well, thank you.
Look at the feet.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. Oh, could you? Maybe I'll send some of these along with me. Get full. thank you.
Do you have another one?
Yeah, thank you. Mm-hmm. There's a few laying up there to dry.
Oh,
postcard. If you address it to somebody and then paint a picture on it, we will mail it out for you tomorrow.
Oh, that is such a cute idea.
We're doing a watercolor challenge this summer. And we've done we've done all kinds of challenges, but we've never done a watercolor. And we have 50 artists that are painting 30 postcards over the summer. And if they want to, they can put their names in a bucket and pull other people's names out, and they'll send to each other.
Nice.
And this group of artists will also be at the City Park on Saturday, the day after tomorrow, to paint together. So we'll be trying to give them a chance to meet each
Saturday.
Other.
Mm-hmm. Oh, fun. That is
so
fun.
If you want to join us, just come down to City Park around noon, bring a sketchbook, and I'll have the same kind of setup here for watercolor cards. And it's just casual.
What a great idea.
Yeah.
Good for you, Tracy.
Yeah.
That's nice to kind of get people back in the spirit of...
Well, we started a Sketchers group for Edmonds a couple of months ago when Brian at the Beacon called me and said...
Right. I read about that.
Yeah. So it kind of started rolling into a bigger and bigger. I'm like, well, I'm going out sketching. I might as well invite a few people. And so now I have a blog. And and I just try to get the word out.
So we should have a... like a show for the Sketchers.
Well, you know, if you wanted to, I've got, well, this month is too quick, but I have dates for July and August if you wanted to put them in the Art Commission for activities for people to come to. It's free. Anybody's
would
welcome.
Would you send me those?
I sure will.
I'll see what I can squeeze in.
Because sometimes it's just nice. I mean, the artists that come, they like sketching outside, but they don't really want to just do it by themselves.
Right.
So it's kind of neat getting to see all their setups and all their little kits that they put together. It's just such a nice group of people. And new people show up all the time.
Yep.
You know, so it's meeting all the artists.
It's a great time to be doing it, too, because bringing people back together.
Yeah. Come together now.
Yeah, giving them a little motivation.
Well, we've been doing it. It's plain air, so of course you're outside, and that's intuitively inherently safe. But we're just getting to the point where we can... start interacting
right.
It feels really good, doesn't it?
It does. It really does. So any suggestions for something for a busy 7-year-old boy who loves Minecraft but he loves art.
On the other side here we have a couple of kits. There's this one where you color with clay, and it's one of the most popular things. And it could be used over and over again. So it has these little boards with pictures. And you take the clay and you smush it on.
And make pictures.
And then you can take it off and do it again. Maybe with different colors. I don't have a little dry. Anyway, that's been really popular. If he's tactile and he likes to squish things, it's not super messy or anything. But he likes to paint. He likes to
draw.
Uh-huh.
He considers himself a
child of and then there's, as you kind of move this way, it gets a little bit more developmentally forward. So it kind of depends on the kid. You know?
Yeah.
Because there's stuff on this side he might look better.
Yeah, okay.
There's some paint by numbers, which are really fun.
Oh, I got that.
They're really hard to find paint by numbers, but I carry as many colors as I can.
Uh-huh.
And,
no,
they're just all encompassing kits where I have to brush on the paint and everything. Some fun pictures.
I'm back.
Hi.
Thank you very much for being in here.
Oh, you got a little bit of sunburn.
Yeah, it was really sunny on the ferry, and I was like, I love that.
It feels so good. Well, the other thing that happened was there was a little bit of unanticipated traffic. In Kingston, the big town of Kingston.
Is that why you missed the first ferry?
Yeah, I literally missed it by like a minute.
Damn.
And I was like, oh no, I'll just have to sit here and eat a crepe. No. But then
weren't under the gun to open the store or anything.
Yeah, it was a time that I don't normally go at. So it was just like, there was just some lights that were acting oddly, you know?
Uh-huh.
Oh, and then this like red pickup truck, like like, it was, like, clearly had been, like, stuck in, like, ferry traffic and was, like, freaking out. And it just, like, screamed out in front of me. And I was like, ah! And I was like,
here.
I was like, ooh. I didn't hit it, but I, like, you know, one of the things where you, like, stomp on the brakes.
Yeah, and have a mini heart attack.
Yeah. And it's like, if I had, like, absolutely ran for the ferry, I probably might have made it. But, like, after that, it was sort of like, I'm just gonna walk.
Uh-huh.
And then I didn't make it. I'm excited because starting in July, I will have my parking spot closer to the ferry.
Yeah, I didn't realize it was that much of a hike.
Yeah, it's I didn't either. It'll be nice.
I was going to do these all in metallics, and then I dipped into the orange. I just couldn't help myself.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Wow.
That's
so
cool.
Yeah.
Have you met Frances Chapin?
Yeah.
Frances, this is my daughter, Bren.
Hello. It's nice to meet you.
Frances is the Edmonds Arts Commission, Arts Leader, manager,
the arts person.
It's so nice to meet you. Hello.
Hello.
I was in the back eating my dinner real fast.
I think I met you so many years ago, Brynn.
Yes.
Yes. I think so.
Yes. Oh, it's lovely to meet you again.
Yes. No. I just, you know, keep hanging around. So.
Yeah. Well, Brynn went through art school, and she got the assistance from the Arts Commission.
Yeah, I was
scholarship.
Oh, from the Arts Festival.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. No, I know that actually.
Yeah,
yes,
so
I do.
That put me through art school. So
excellent. Well, not me, because that would be the Arts Festival Foundation.
Hey, did you do your presentation for the Waterfront Center?
I did.
How did it go?
It was fun.
I have to go on. Have they posted it yet?
Yeah, they're all posted.
Oh, good. I have to go and watch the other. I did
posted.
The first one.
I know. I watched you.
Yeah. I spent like a week on that. I was like, oh, my God.
You know, I absolutely believe that. You did a phenomenal job.
I am.
And it took a lot of time to put that stuff together.
Yeah, because you want to get the images and then sound somewhat coherent when you're talking to
Well, one of the arts commissioners... you can get a transcript
exactly.
from YouTube.
Oh,
so they didn't do the recording with a transcript, but you can get one off of YouTube. So
yeah.
She downloaded that.
Really?
And sent it to me and said, can you correct this and fill this in, you know, so that we have a written document to go with
really?
The presentation. So
really?
You could do that too.
Oh.
I mean, I thought it was interesting because her point was, you know, if, I mean, with the arts, with the public art, and the or the outdoor art,
yeah.
that it would be a really good educational thing for new arts commissioners.
Definitely.
Oh right, yeah.
Anyway, you did a fabulous job.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You set the bar very high.
I was glad that I did it.
Yeah.
What is, you know, the big mystery between the Arts Festival Foundation and the Arts Festival? And,
yeah.
And I was cracking up because I'm trying to think. Julaine had sent me images from the very first 1950s ladies, and I was like, that looks like me and Sue in this picture.
Right.
You know, I was like laughing because
yep.
some things never change.
Yep.
Know? Yeah.
Yep. No, I know.
Oh, I love that.
No, it was great. You had some of those old pictures are some of my favorites.
Yeah.
I threw some old ones in too.
I'm going to have to check it.
Me.
I will check it out.
I did a little piece on the fountain.
Yeah.
Well, I thought
the one that got ran over.
Yeah, it's been locked up, but there are a lot of people who live here.
Are you doing any of these?
Yeah, any of these.
Yeah, you might want to address it first because once you paint it.
She just did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm catching up.
I should probably put it in though.
You're
going to
get clay.
Yeah, we found that we needed to tell people to address it before they paint it because then you paint it and it's wet. You can't flip it over.
Yeah.
These are all kinds of different watercolors. All of these shiny ones.
Yeah, this is about a trial.
Yeah.
And there's watercolor markers over there.
Yeah, these ones over here on these little trays are super high-end, watercolors. So it's kind of a fun to kind of test out what the different kinds are.
Yeah, people say, why do I need to pay $10 for that tube of watercolor? And it's like, oh, I see now.
Yeah.
It goes, boom, you know, it really travels.
Yeah.
It's much more satisfying.
But just paint whatever you like, and if you find you don't like it, then you say, oh, it's abstract.
That's a good point.
plan. Mm-hmm.
I've had to do that a couple of times. Did you come down for art walk, or did you just happen upon it?
I actually came down for it just to see what it was about.
Nice.
Yeah.
Is this the person you've been to?
I've been here to Art Spot before and like walked around this area, but I'm still getting familiar with it. Even though I've been here for like a few years, but I'm originally from California, so I'm still just getting to know
And you're from California.
You can't say I'm from California. I grew up here, but I didn't live in California.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
But moved up in March at the beginning of COVID. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah, you haven't had a chance to meet anybody.
No. Oh, yeah, no. That wasn't the greatest time to go.
What part of California are you from?
We're from the Bay Area, and we lived in San Diego for a few years.
Awesome. That's so cool. I went to college in the Bay Area.
I lived in Richmond for all my life, so I was like right down there.
Yeah, for sure. And then I've been to San Diego just a couple of times for Comic-Con, so sorry about Comic-Con.
Oh, no.
Like, I know that. I'm sure
I've always wanted to go to Comic-Con.
It's fun. If you ever get the chance, I think everywhere you go, just because it's crazy.
I heard. I've been wanting to go forever. I'm kind of like an anime fan, so I've been wanting to go forever.
Yeah, they have some really cool panels. You get to meet some really cool artists and see how they work.
Oh, I would love to see that. That'd be super cool.
Yeah.
Does he live close by where you can do the project with him, Francis?
Well, I'm going to go stay
with him. Yeah, the Gaslight District is really fun. Yeah. It's a really good
So pick out something that you'd like to do, too.
Yeah.
You can play, too.
I will play.
Of course.
I was just debating whether to just get some clay or to get this. Because it's kind
that way you get both clay
inspiring.
And
inspiring.
Yeah.
I'm good. Yeah, no, I need some things to, some rainy day things.
Yeah. If you want to get just clay, those clay tunes are fun. And there's armatures in that same little display. So you can make like an armature of like a little thing and then put the clay on it, it'll move.
Oh, interesting. Oh. Is that what these are? Safety bones?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, I kind of like that.
That whole section is mostly because of Bryn, because she was making little animations with clay when, I don't know what, like fourth grade or something with the video camera?
Ninth grade.
I love those days.
Okay, so he loves to work in animation.
Oh, cool.
Hence, I'll bring it
back. Oh, awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Did you get a chance to work in the industry at all?
I did. I worked at a studio called Stupid Bunny Studios for a number of years. They're most famous for making Robot Chicken.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so I worked on seasons 8 through 10 of that and a couple other shows and commercials.
Oh, that's super fun. How did you like it?
I really, really enjoyed it a lot. Yeah.
Are you going Joanne, this is cool.
What made you come back here?
Well, I grew up here, and I wanted to, I wanted to buy a house and start a family, and I didn't want to see that so far away.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Definitely, I like this area for that purpose and kind of like settling down because it is a lot more low-key.
Yeah.
Kind of hectic.
My husband and neither of us are from Los Angeles, so it's like, I would say it's like the best city to be in your 20s.
Yeah, it really is. Because other than that, and even when I think we were in LA, but like San Diego area, and just being if you're near LA at all, it's like not the greatest place.
Like we had a ton of fun there, and we did what we like set out to do, which is work in animation.
Yeah.
But like after a little while, you kind of be like, okay, well if I want to start making any more money, I have to become like a supervisor. I have to producer, and you're like, I don't want to be in meetings all day. I like actually making art.
Yeah.
So you kind of get to the top of your ladder, and you're like, well, here I am.
Yeah.
I guess this is where I'm at.
Yeah, I definitely was interested in animation for a while too, but I didn't know exactly what direction to go in.
Yeah.
Especially since I lean more towards like the anime style.
Oh, fun.
Yeah, it was just, you know, and also, you know, I grew up being told, you know, like it's not a viable career, so I tried really hard for like a few years, and then I'm like, I'm just gonna work with animals for 7 years, so I did that.
What do you do now?
I just work at a as a receptionist at a holistic clinic now.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, working with animals is strenuous on your body.
I believe it.
Hey, how are you?
Hi, welcome to
Postcard. We're inviting people to paint a watercolor postcard, and then we'll mail it out for you tomorrow.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, so we're all painting postcards and having a grand time.
That's a cool idea.
Yeah, that was one of the things I found working in stop motion animation specifically. That's what I was doing, but you work with a lot of chemicals.
Yeah.
I saw a lot of the people who've been working in the industry for like 30 years, and I was like, I don't know if I can. I'm really enjoying this now, but I don't know if I want to put my body through that. It was really fun, but like I was just sort of like, oh my god, like I don't know. Sometimes your dream job isn't as dreamy as you think it's gonna be.
Yeah.
But I'm super glad I did it, and California is a super fun place to. To get to, you know, spread your wings.
Yeah, it totally is. I really miss California a lot of the time for that because there is so much to do.
Yeah.
So many interesting spots to discover down there.
It's such a pretty state, too.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. And I'm a big fan of Disneyland, too, so it's like right there. I miss having it in my backyard.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, I really thought they were going to paint a postcard.
Mm. People are, you know, easily. It was really funny because when I started the artwork started at 5 p.m. and I was here by myself, and the only people I could get to paint postcards were like little kids, and they were way into it.
Hey, there's one up there that says "To Tom from Tom," and it's written really tiny.
Oh yeah, Tom was cool.
And on the back, it doesn't have it's not addressed to anybody. So
because I got. His sister wrote out their address.
Oh, so. I was going to say, we need to find someone named Tom to send it to.
I'm on it.
Oh, cool.
But yeah, Tom and Tom. Look at it.
That is so funny. Who did that? This lady that came in.
That's awesome. Yeah, I had to get some grown-ups to be like, so far all the little kids are breaking.
You know, that's the way it is sometimes. Yeah, these extra ones that we're doing, we can send out to our paint by postcard. Challenge artists. Yeah, I've gone over to these dance with colors and I'm not dipped into these. These are like artist quality. It's a huge difference.
Yeah, so one of the things, the main difference between like student quality and artist quality paints really of any kind is the pigment density. So there's literally more yellow and more color in there than there is here.
Oh, cool.
Like,
they kind of see it too, even though it's a slightly different color yellow. But.
Yeah. It's, the colors are less muddy and they're easier to mix. And they're, more vibrant.
Yeah, they look like they are.
The, Gallerini has gotten some action tonight.
Oh, yeah? Oh,
somebody put a really beautiful pair of earrings in there.
Oh, wow.
I'm just playing colors and hoping that it turns into something.
That's where all the greats do. Whether they admit it or not. Hi, good evening.
Hello, welcome to Hi.
Would you like to paint a postcard?
I'm not tonight. I'm going to go.
You were here earlier, weren't you?
Well, no, I wasn't here earlier today, but I've got postcards. I'm getting a little behind. But I'm going away this weekend, so I'm planning on catching up.
Ooh,
oh, that'll be nice.
That'll be really fun.
It's going to be our third island hop of the spring.
That'll be nice.
We've been to Whidbey and Orcas, and this weekend we're going to Camino.
Ooh.
Islands you don't have to get in a plane for.
Oh, gosh.
That's
fun,
nice.
Huh? That's cool.
I'm looking forward to Saturday where the sketching group is going to meet at the park.
I know, and I'm going to miss it because I'm going to be up and away.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
But you know what? There'll be another
oh, yeah.
one in June. I mean, July and August. Yeah. Yeah.
I'll be here for that.
So make sure we get those dates out.
Great to see some wonderful ideas.
It's been really fun. Some people have been posting their postcards to like Instagram and uh-huh. Facebook, and it's really fun seeing like all the different styles that people yep. are doing.
Well, I'll have to check it out. But right now, some Monty Python.
Yeah, enjoy that. Have fun. Yeah.
What's the Monty Python?
The theater is doing a free showing of Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
No. Today,
and I'm like,
that would be so fun to go see that in the theater with other people.
They're doing it. They had a free showing at 5 and they're doing another free showing at 8.
Oh, man. I wonder if we could, you know, we could sneak over there and see the 8 o'clock one. Wait, you're closing because Mason opened, right?
I figured we'd close together.
Mm-hmm. See what I'm saying about those colors?
Yeah, they're really nice.
Yeah, it's interesting because it's like you're like the upfront cost of getting the more expensive like fancy watercolors is can be intimidating, but in the end you're getting so much more color because you can really play with it. You can like stretch it out more and mix it and do and a lot of fun with it.
Yeah, really cool. I haven't played very much with watercolor. I think I got the Winsor & Newton, like their little like portable set.
Yeah, that's a really great one to start out with.
I've tried it a couple times and I feel like it's not as intuitive for me to do it. I started trying gouache, and I feel like it's a little bit easier for to handle.
I definitely agree that gouache is a little bit more like user-friendly. It's a little bit more forgiving. Not very many people know about gouache, which I think is a shame, because gouache is, like, so fun.
Yeah, I really enjoyed doing gouache. I ended up just trying it out and ended up doing, like, a random portrait.
Oh,
and it was
awesome.
Ended up, like, way better than I thought. I'm like, this is really fun, and I ended up doing it for a few hours. And
oh, that's great.
Super cool.
That's the way that art, that's, like, the ideal art experience.
I think so. I always, the days that I always end up doing something are the days that I never intended to do anything.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Good. Can it come out on Saturday?
Yes.
I love the idea of the throwdown.
Yeah. It's the throwdown.
The throwdown.
What's the throwdown? What are we trying down? Gauntlets?
No, it's not competitive.
So
it's
down
your art.
Oh.
Yes, so everybody can look at it.
Oh, that's cool.
The throwdown's at the end. What? Well,
at the end, yeah. So I just did one today, actually.
Yeah?
I one
the you are getting into this.
It's
wow.
Yeah.
Like, these are all
and, yeah. So you have a designated time where everybody gets back after a event, and then show all your work down, and like, just show and tell.
That's awesome. That's
get to
cool.
see what everyone did.
Yeah. Like,
this one's
water.
So fun.
Oh, you could come for
it. Yeah.
I'm thinking about it.
It's another trip over for you, though.
Yeah, we're heading over also on Sunday for Father's Day. I'd like to come because, I don't know, last time, I feel like the paintbrush was picked on like, my baby. I'm like, gorgeous.
You guys could stay overnight if you want to. Don't want to go back and forth.
That's a good idea. That was neat.
Yeah. Hi, how you doing? Would you like to paint a watercolor postcard?
Okay, thank you, Bill.
I enjoy looking your room.
Thank you.
I'm
Mason, do you want to try places so you can paint one?
Back and feed Pippin.
Okay.
A whole bunch of dogs were barking like way up the street, and pretty soon, like, Pippin couldn't stand it anymore. He's like, woof.
Yeah.
He's in the back room.
Pippin's only 15 pounds.
He's a little guy.
his big bark is very low-key, so.
My dog ends up barking after a bunch of dogs bark too. He's a big boy, he's 80 pounds, but he's also a golden retriever, and he'd probably roll over as soon as people came over too, so he just sounds intimidating, but he doesn't do very much.
Can I take a picture of you painting?
Sure.
That picture you're doing is just fantastic.
Thanks. I don't know what I'm doing, to be honest.
Playing around.
Came in and said the picture was falling down. I just now remembered that. I should finish his eyes. This whole thing with this big giant brush.
That's awesome.
You know, it can be done.
Huh. Okay. I don't think I can put any more paint on this thing. I think it's full.
Yeah.
It starts like beating up on you.
Yeah.
Peeling up on you.
This is cool. Something random.
It's beautiful. It kind of looks southwestern.
Thanks. I know, it kind of looks like my pants.
You got a theme going.
Yeah.
Well, we'll put that in the mail tomorrow morning.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I appreciate it. Enjoy the
rest of your evening.
Thanks.
You guys too.
How pretty that is.
It's gorgeous. Let's show it to our viewing audience.
Oh, there's two people in there.
It's Ming. Ming and Ming.
Well,
There's
two people.
It says number two.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Nobody's commented since the beginning. That's okay. Yeah, Ming was watching me paint that flower one.
We have enough stamps for all these, Bren?
Yeah.
Let's go get some more. This is one of my favorite ones ever.
Bikini bottom. liking.
Thank you.
Painterly.
Yeah. Well, over here we are painting watercolor postcards if you'd like to do one.
Yes.
Yeah. If you'd like to fill out an address either to yourself or somebody else at the beginning, then we'll do them in the mail tomorrow.
Yeah. These are very cool, and I am intrigued by all of the paint.
Yeah.
Oh, what brand is that?
So these are the Jack Richardson semi-moist watercolors. We actually have them in stock. Not this particular set. We sell them as individual colors.
Mm-hmm.
These ones up here are Dan Smith, which is top of the line watercolors, and then these are also Jack Richardson.
I feel like I've seen those like on Instagram.
Yeah.
I've been trying to find like a really good metallic
Yeah. We'll play with these a little bit, but also play with the Dan Smith ones, and you'll see the difference. These ones I must admit are really But the reason why, as with any kind of paint, one kind of paint is more expensive than another is it's because it has a higher pigment.
You know, gems cost more than rocks.
I believe that.
You like shiny things.
Yes.
Should I? Come on, Lovey.
I think you should.
It's too late. Your mom has everything for God.
Oh, well, I already cut it
out. No longer coming
here. Blake.
Mr. Blake.
Where is Jasmine?
Good, how are you?
Art
wall? Yeah, thank you.
Well, enjoy looking around. If you'd like to paint a postcard, you're more than welcome to.
Thank you.
I have become completely distracted.
Yes.
Alright, we can, because that's what's important.
Yeah, there's been this really cool trend that's been coming out recently.
Why am I writing Mar? I'm writing your name instead of my name.
Here, you can change it to... They won't look as pretty.
Wait. I-C-H... Hey, italics cover... Right? I think I did pretty well with that.
Should I put, like, it on top of another color, or will it like be
you're gonna find out when you do it.
Yeah, so one thing to remember about watercolors is that they will always reconstitute with more water. So if you do like a layer of blue at the bottom and then you put yellow on top, you'll get green. But it can be something that can be something that you can like play with on purpose, but just something to keep in mind if you want something to be a really pure color.
You should not put a second one onto it.
One thing that a lot of people have been doing is using the opaque, solid colors, and then they'll do the metallics on top of that, because the metallics are pretty transparent. This is just a great opportunity, low stakes, no pressure, to experiment and see what works or what doesn't work for you.
It's also really fun whenever you mix up the water. It's got all these fun shimmeries.
It looks like,
Can I borrow some towels? Come on.
Updated it.
Yeah, this is Spotify, and I feel like sometimes Spotify still will have like a slightly weird version of a song. Like it will be like the same band, but it'll be like a live version or something like that. And I'm like, what is this? Why is this song?
Why does it sound as if it was a song?
Going for like an Aurora Borealis galaxy kind of thing.
I didn't really have a plan other than I wanted to use all the very pretty colors.
Yes. No, I've been doing this for like almost 3 hours. Right. At this point, so I had a big pot. I cleaned all these ones. So I had some really weird abstract ones, just being like every color.
This is such
a cool, like, ocean-y, like, tea. I like that. Yeah. I find myself attracted to those kind of colors a lot. Right now, you wouldn't be able to tell because I'm, like, being like, I'm going to do something different. I'm going to do red. I've been painting, like, ocean ones, like, all evening, but now I'm doing red.
I like the fact that the paint that's in there is maintained. The door looks really nice.
Yeah, it's kind of fun. It also reminds me of those, like, it was like a gel thing, like, in the 90s or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, they had that, like, swirly, slimy thing. I don't know.
Yeah, like the thing that you held.
Yeah,
I don't. It was like a tube.
Yeah,
and like you can't hold it because it's like
God.
A.
Yeah.
Thank you for reminding me.
Yeah. I don't know what I never knew what they were called, but that's exactly what I'm thinking of.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Thank you for knowing what I was talking about.
Yeah, you know, it's nice when someone knows.
Squishy, shimmery, and like sometimes it would have like toys in them.
There was a tube that was not hollow, but you could turn it inside.
Yeah, you could turn them inside out. It was like mind blowing.
You know, at your age at the time, yes, it was.
Yes, I was. My mind was constantly being surprised at that age.
It was a crazy world.
Yeah. Like, there's shimmery self inside turning out in tube things. Like, this is incredible.
What even?
I'm gonna go watch The Lion King now.
That was funny. I really like that. Well, that's fun. Did you do the black?
I didn't. My mom drew this, and I'm coloring it in.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Ah, I see there's a bit of art in the family.
Yes. This is actually my mom's art store. She's the owner.
Okay. Oh, I love that.
It's doing something.
Yeah.
That's why you're out here, too.
Indeed.
Good daughter.
And then my siblings are around here somewhere. They're running a record store. Hold them eggs by and join them around.
That's purple.
Oh.
I
don't need
to. Yeah, some of the dark colors look kind of like a mystery. Like, what color is it going to be? It's like it's black. But it's not.
It's purple. It's not cute.
This might just be an abstract blob of colors.
That's okay.
Which I'm totally okay with.
Yeah. I mean, isn't that what Aurora Borealis is?
True. I was going to attempt to do some sort of, like, maybe silhouetted landscape.
Ooh, that'd be cool too.
You little girl.
Well, if you like let it dry pretty good, and especially if you want to over it with a darker color, I think you could definitely do that. Yeah, I think if you got that one and you let it
this one.
Yeah, if you let the paint be thicker,
yeah.
That might achieve that kind of effect. But only I would imagine only if after the paint underneath is pretty dry.
Yeah.
Yeah, because like if the paint underneath is wet, it's definitely going to mix together, but if it's dry, it's going to take longer to start mixing together.
We just got in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Well, okay. These are possibilities.
I like this like pastel-y.
This is like this is the Jack Richardson one, and it's like their pearlescent line.
Hmm.
Love it.
I could have written mom, but I wrote him.
She's in, let's see, you're 30 years old? In 30 years.
Probably before then. Not before then, after then. Mom, we've like done art classes together.
We did a ceramics class, remember that?
And that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, but it was ceramics.
Is that not art?
Yeah, but I've never like, I guess I could call that to me to like construction as opposed to.
Artistic construction? Still art though. Ceramics is art.
Yes. I went to art school, and you could definitely major in ceramics.
Yeah, for sure. Like, it does. She's like, well, that's more construction. I'm like, it's all art.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a whole other table. Oh, no color. Wait, are these the same colors?
No, it is from the same set, though. So this is half of the set. So if you wanted to bring that over and play with those ones, too.
Oh, gosh. So I was like, these are very pastel-y. These look a little bit bright.
Yeah.
That's what I did today.
I started today, indeed I did.
No, I said that's what I did today.
What?
Quit my day job.
Yeah. Ooh, you have some newfound freedom?
Yep, I'm very thrilled.
Congratulations. It's a bold move, I like it.
Yeah. I have part-time work set up and like for the school year. I work for a teacher, I work in school year
things.
And so, having a break for this.
Yeah, well, that sounds fantastic.
Yeah. I've been working. I never stopped working.
I believe it. So. Well, especially after last
year. Yeah.
Do you keep kids or older?
Kids, like elementary or preschool age. Yeah. And it's like, yeah, it wasn't really like ever a break. It was just kind of a pivot to a different kind of, yeah.
Well, congratulations.
Try and do more art and do more photography.
Well, I hope you enjoy that. And find success.
Do you do art full time or?
Yeah, well, I work here full time, but my previous job to this, because this is my family store, but
right.
I was working full time at an animation studio in Los Angeles.
Cool.
Yeah, so the field that I went into was animation.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's such a crazy medium too.
Yeah, it was really fun. I really enjoyed it.
What's your like favorite kind of animation like style?
The kind of animation I was working in was actually stop motion animation.
Cool.
Yeah, so I went old school.
I love that.
Yeah.
Like, I love like one of my favorite movies for Halloween time is Coraline.
Oh, nice! Awesome.
Just like incredible.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I have a bunch of friends who are working
at
Leica now.
At where?
Leica, the company
that I work. Oh, yeah. Wait, I've heard of Leica.
Yeah.
I have a friend from college. I don't know that we talk super often, but, like, he does, game animation.
Oh,
and,
nice. Awesome.
Like, kind of, like, post-apocalyptic style, like.
That's cool.
You know, big giant buildings with like, it's like steampunky and I'm like, whoa, that's nuts. Like, he posts stuff of him doing stuff in Blender and I'm like, that's crazy.
Yeah. My husband is a 3D guy. He does like VR and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's like, I understand a little bit of it because I, you know, when you have your degree in animation, they like make you take 3D classes.
Right.
But like, the stuff that they're able to do now and like in the time that since I was a student is like just absolutely insane. It's so cool.
It's really cool to just like, I love how much like animation is, it's not really like thought of as like a separate like genre anymore. Like
yeah.
You have like so many things across the board and but it's, that's very cute. Weed money, ice cream money. Thanks.
They're sold out of the ice cream money, but the weed money is still a lot.
Okay, I'm really liking this so far. I love this palette. This is amazing. You said it's part of the same set?
Yes, this is a set of 20. So this right
oh,
here
there's like
in.
Set.
Yeah.
How much is that?
Here they have everything you need for $48.99.
Well, I have brushes, and I have palettes, and I have...
So, this one here, for these colors, $12.99 for all 20 of the colors.
Buying that, done.
All right, then.
The only downside to this particular set is this brush is kind of.
I've got my own brushes.
If you've got your own brushes, you're in good hands.
But, like, also, my brushes are not, like, the most high quality brushes. Do you have, like, a good set that you could recommend?
Yeah, I'm going to recommend some sets.
Well, I know. That's why.
We have some of those.
Some, a few.
We have some sets. We have
small, so much. No, probably not small. Should I just plunk this back in the water?
Yeah, that's good. Okay. Mason can show you the brushes.
I want to add a horizon, but I'm going to dry this.
No, she's going to.
I dry it.
Did you not listen? I said I want to add a horizon.
Okay, but I have to dry it.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to carry it around and dry it.
I love
it. Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Thank
you. You have a lovely day.
I've always wanted to go to one of those movies across the street that I never ever have yet, but
I mean, you can buy a house if you want to, Mom.
No, I'm just thinking maybe sometime when we know what the movie is that's coming to the movie theater, it would be fun to go.
Yeah. Thanks everybody for watching. Have a good rest of your night.